Watch out, guys. The Browns are going to break out next year.
I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero tell, get my baby right now.
Okay, so the Browns are probably one of the worst franchises in the NFL. And honestly, last season we can honestly say that they really underperformed. But the thing is about the Browns, who was their head coach last year? Freddie Kitchens, okay? Freddie Kitchens was probably one of the worst head coaches I've ever seen in my life. Like, the guy did not know anything. Like, I remember this one time where they ran a halfback draw on third and, like, 25. I mean, like, come on. Come on. If I'm Baker Mayfield, I'm like, we have to throw. Like, bro, how do you even get a third and 25? But to run a draw on a third and 25 and it's crucial you need the first down, I mean, that's insane to me. Like, I know Nick Chubb is good, but, I mean, he's not that good. So, yeah. The simple fact that they have a much better head coach and they've got a new GM that actually really knows what he's doing. They have, they get a third year with Baker Mayfield. They got OBJ back, Jarvis back, Nick Chubb, a good old line. They added pieces on their defense. So, I mean, it's very easy to say that the Browns could really break out, and I have them going to the playoffs next year in the wild card. I don't have them winning the division because I feel like that division is so tough to win because the Ravens are an absolute powerhouse. They're just so stacked. But the Browns are really stacked too, and I really think that if the Browns can just put it together this year, under the new head coach and new GM, I mean, it's no question that the Browns can make the playoffs. They're really going to be a very nice team, along with the Raiders, I mean, and the Chargers, too. I mean, but don't get it mistaken. If I'm wrong and Baker Mayfield absolutely stinks it up, he's gone, because that GM did not draft him. That wasn't the coach that drafted him. I mean, at this point, he would have been in three different systems under two different GMs. It's really nothing else you can honestly say, but, I mean, he's done. And he's really not, like, the one. And see, I don't really want to be harsh on Baker Mayfield because I'm a fan of Baker Mayfield. I root for Baker Mayfield. And I really want to see him succeed because if Baker Mayfield succeeds, I succeed. But the thing is, Baker Mayfield just, like, he's not one of these guys where he's going to take over the league. He's just a good quarterback. But right now, he's not playing like that. And his game is fundamentals and mechanics. That is his game. That's what he thrives off of. That is the reason why he was number one pick. Actually, no. The reason why he was number one pick is because of his personality and how guys gravitate around the locker room. And his personality really, like, that engaged with the old Browns GM. For that reason, I'm probably just going to have to say that the Browns go around 11-5 next year. You'll see in my prediction video, but the Browns are going to be actually very nice. And I can't wait for you guys to see because I really see it how it is. And the Browns are going to be very nice. Now, whether they go far in the playoffs, that's up to them. But I think they're going to have a really good season, during the season, and just watch out, especially for Odell. He's going to have a big year. Just watch. Because Odell is going to be a really nice asset to that team. And the fact is, Odell, he's been scrutinized so much, and he's really a top five wide receiver. I mean, honestly, I can name you three wide receivers better than Odell. Because, and don't even say Michael Thomas, because the thing that Odell does, he burns receivers. His footwork is so nice, and he's so technically sound, and he's so talented that, I mean, the only reason why he's not in that top three discussion is because Baker Mayfield and the offense that they've been in. The Baker Mayfield is the reason why Odell's not top three. Because if you watch the film, Baker Mayfield, on countless occasions, never throws him the ball. And it's really alarming because if Baker Mayfield misses those reads on something that he's supposed to make as a pocket reading, technically sound quarterback, how is he going to make his money in the NFL? I don't know. Honestly, I think the Browns should have went with Saquon Barkley and then picked up Sam Darnold. I mean, or if Sam Darnold's gone, I mean, you always have Josh Allen or Josh Rosen. Or I mean, honestly, nobody thought Lamar was going to be what he is, and he wouldn't have been who he was if it wasn't for that system. So I mean, and I think Sam Darnold would be so much of a better quarterback if he landed somewhere else. But it is what it is. And I think the Giants honestly should have drafted Sam Darnold over Saquon because it's just not working right now. But Daniel Jones is a great quarterback, and I really like Daniel Jones. And I really feel like Daniel Jones is going to be a really good quarterback in this NFL. And he's their franchise guy for a long time. Now, whether people say he's the second version of Eli Manning, I don't see that. The only thing that's really similar is their look or, like, the personality that they give off. But other than that, I mean, he's way more mobile than Eli. He runs way more. He's way more versatile. He's way more of the now. He's way more up to date as far as QB game. So, as far as that wise, I can't really see why you don't think that this guy is going to be a number one threat for the Giants. I mean, he's really good, and I really like him. But back to the topic, I mean, the Browns are just, they're going to be nice. And just watch what I tell you, bro. Like, the Browns and also, a lot of people really mistake Jarvis for being the best wide receiver on that team. He is the slot guy, and Baker loves to go to the slot. So, regardless, the slot's going to get way more targets. And Jarvis got way, way, way more targets than Odell. But Odell got open way, way, way more than Jarvis. So, that's what I have to say about that. What's up, guys? I'm Jack and Tube. If you really enjoyed the content that you just saw, make sure you guys go like, comment, subscribe. I'm really trying to grow the channel. I talk about sports all the time, so, and it's a really cool place to just chill and stuff. So if you really like this content, make sure you guys hit the like and just comment and subscribe. Really hit the subscribe button. We're trying to hit our next goal. So yeah, guys, tell me what you guys thought, and yeah, guys. Could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent around. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell the hero, tell, get my baby 35.